Can I start by acknowledging Peter and June Jackson for gracing us with that welcome as mana whenua? It's really important to us to acknowledge the ancestors and the significant places in this wonderful place that we're meeting today. So thank you for the welcome. Can I also acknowledge you, Bill, Honourable Bill Shorten? We've got a really close relationship with our sister party in Australia. You're probably the closest relatives that we do the most with. But none of us can remember a time when we have had the leader of the Australian Labor Party here. So thank you for honouring our conference. And it's also really significant that we have on the stage both the two first democratically elected leaders of both the Australian Labor Party and the New Zealand Labor Party sitting together. A historic moment. So, Members of Parliament, New Zealand councillors, candidates, members, supporters, welcome to the third day of our Congress. In 76 days' time, we need a Labor government with a positive plan for New Zealand so that all New Zealanders benefit from the recovery. But this election is going to go down to the wire. We need to run the strongest, smartest campaign we've ever run to deliver a Labor victory. Victory's in sight, but it won't be handed to us. We're going to need to go out and work harder than ever before and inspire all our supporters to go out too. Our leader, David Cunliffe, is driving our campaign. David has the values, the vision, and the determination to lead Labor to victory. And David will work together with all New Zealanders to make positive, long-term change. We have the leader. We also have a powerful plan. I want to acknowledge David Parker, Nigel Harworth and Michael Wood for their leadership, along with the Policy Council, the Policy Committees and everyone who contributed. We've got the plan New Zealand needs. Today you'll hear about the difference that plan will make to people's lives, to their work, to their families, and to their homes. I want to talk to you about my community, the Coromandel community, and the difference that Labor's plan will make to my community and every community like it across provincial New Zealand. The Coromandel is one of the most beautiful but poorest electorates in the country. It needs decent jobs for our kids. But when I go home, it's to photographs, because our kids, all their cousins, and pretty well many of their schoolmates as well, have all gone overseas. Labor's plan for vibrant regional development will bring more of our kids home to decent jobs. We need affordable housing too. You drive up the road from my place and you get to Coromandel Town. Coromandel Town has beautiful million-dollar homes with wonderful sea views. But look a bit more closely and you'll see that those homes are holiday makers. They're only occupied in the weekends. Meanwhile, many of the locals rent cheap batches that they even have to vacate at Christmas. That is growing inequality that is unacceptable in a country like this. And then there's the forest and the sea that we all love. Only after massive protest, this government pulled back from mining in our most precious conservation estate. But since then, they've granted several exploration permits in this very land and on the foreshore. And that's not the future that we want. And my community's story is repeated town after town across New Zealand. We need to change the government. Our communities need a Labor government where regional development is a priority, with decent jobs, affordable homes, and the protection of our iconic natural environment. Members, our party is ready. We have the values, we have the plan, and we have the team, and now it's up to us to campaign. We know that campaigning has changed. We know a lot more about what works from the best international campaigns, but more importantly, from our own results recently in both the Ikararafati and Christchurch East by-election. And we know the three things that are most important. One, it's about the party vote nationwide. That's what will win us government, not electorate campaigns, the party vote nationwide. Secondly, it's about identifying those marginal voters and having real conversations, tens of thousands of real conversations with these voters. And then finally, we've got 17 days to turn out our vote. In 2012, we achieved major changes to transform our party into a modern, energised movement for change. And now we are harnessing that energy and people power in our campaign to win. So I'm excited because we've made the changes that are critical to a winning campaign. Last year, we achieved the biggest membership growth in decades. And that's really important because this year our members, old and new, have hit the streets and the phones more than ever before. We've made nearly five times as many calls already as in the last election. We've moved our focus away from solely electorate campaigns, and our new campaigning hubs are pumping. Through the hubs, we've identified tens of thousands of supporters committed to changing the government. I want to mention one. I want to mention Bay and Lakes Hub. It's just one example, but it is a standout. This new hub, which really wasn't one of our most organised regions, has exceeded its targets months ahead of schedule. And members, it's the same story in hub after hub. Then there's our campaign colleges. They've provided more intensive training to our candidates and campaign teams than ever before. And I thank and acknowledge Damien Ogden and Campaign Action in Australia for their support. Yesterday's program deepened that focus and commitment on taking best practice organising home in every electorate. Across New Zealand, our voter identification effort has been excellent, and now it's time to build on that groundswell of energy and support with personal conversations everywhere. This election, it's a lot less about stuff like billboards and hoardings, and a lot more about personal communication that makes politics relevant. Our leader, David Cunliffe, is out there every day, but now we need every member, every Labor supporter and neighbour, and all our newest volunteers telling our Labor stories. Then in September, we have that 17 days this time for getting out our vote. We've got somewhere around 250,000 previous Labor voters who didn't vote last time, and we need to get them off the couch and into the polling booths throughout that 17 days. Members and candidates, you have made an outstanding start, and that's a great platform for the rest of our campaign. Thank you all. Thanks also to our caucus and New Zealand councillors for leading the changes. Special thanks to our General Secretary Tim Barnett and the staff in both the party and the parliament, whose dedication has been stellar. I also acknowledge the important contribution of the CTU Get Out the Vote campaign. The 50th parliamentary term is almost over. During this term, we farewelled the late Parakura Horemeyer with deep affection, and we farewelled Charles Chevelle, Leanne Dalziel and Shane Jones. In September, Ross Robertson, Darian Fenton and Rajan Prasad will retire from Parliament. Their contribution to Labor and to New Zealand is warmly acknowledged, and this includes Ross's long service to the people of South Auckland, Darian's commitment to low-paid workers and Rajan's representation of ethnic communities. Thank you all. One of the best things I've got to do as President is select our candidates this year. This year, it's been a real privilege with vigorous contests right across the country between outstanding New Zealanders. Thank you to all our electorate and list candidates. You are an exceptional and diverse group giving so much to our movement. Our Māori vote strategy includes campaigning to win back all seven Māori seats, as well as Nanaia, Kelvin, Mecca and Renoir. We have outstanding candidates for Labor in the other Māori seats, and we are seeing a generational shift in our Māori caucus and candidates. We have young, dynamic, future leaders who really embody the Māori proverb about the new net going fishing. I'm proud to introduce to Congress our new candidates in the Māori seats. Pini Henare, standing in Tamaki Makaurau. Rāwiri Waititi, standing in Wairiki. And Adrian Rurafi in Te Tai Hauru. Members, these three electorates span nearly half of all of the general electorates. So integrating your campaign wherever possible across the general and Māori electorates will make a real difference to winning these seats back. Please make connections with them today if you haven't already. We've got the values, we've got the policy, we've got the leader, and we've got the organisation. And now it's up to our campaign. None of us want deepening inequality and a degrading environment. Our children deserve a better New Zealand. Our challenge now is to take our message to Kiwis and give them the chance on September the 20th to truly vote positive.